أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم ورتل القرآن ترتيلا
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم Viewers of MTA, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. In accordance with the instructions given by our beloved Imam Hadrat Amirul Mumineen Khalifatul Masih Khamis Ayyadahullahu ta'ala bin Nasril Aziz, we are going to start a series of programs called At-Tartil, in which the correct pronunciation of the Holy Quran will be learned, taught and practiced. The main syllabus for practicing these rules of recitation will be part 30, last part of the Holy Quran. And in each program, we will focus one particular surah and will learn and practice one rule of recitation. With this very brief introduction, I like to have the introduction of the participant of this class. And I start with from my right. Can I ask your name?
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuhu. My name is Abdurrahman Cham.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. My name is Hassan Saubi.
Okay. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. My name is Sahil Mahmood.
Okay, thank you very much. Okay, let us start our class. You see that what is the need of learning and teaching the correct pronunciation of the Holy Quran? First of all, you can see on the screen that there is a quote from the Holy Quran, and this is from Allah the Exalted in Surah Al-Muzzammil, وَرَتِّلِ الْقُرْآنَ تَرْتِيلًا, and recite the Quran melodiously and thoughtfully. And the next, you have a quote from the Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, khairukum man ta'allama al-Qur'ana wa 'allama, the best among you is the one who learns the Quran and teaches it. Now remember that this hadith has two parts: one, to learn the Holy Quran, and then to teach to others. The promised Messiah alaihi wasallam also said, Quran Majeed ko bhi khush ilhani se padhna chahiye. The Holy Quran should be recited in a melodious tone. So from these quotes from the Holy Quran, from Hadith, and an extract from the Holy Promised Messiah alayhi wasalam, all these show that what is the importance of learning and teaching the Holy Quran in a melodious tone, in a best possible manner. Now, next basic points to be noted and to be remembered. First of all, there are 29 letters in the Arabic alphabets. So if you count from Alif to Ya, which is already highlighted here, Alif, Ba, Ta, Tha, if you continue, these are 29 letters. Second one, Arabic is written and read from right to left. English is written and read from left to right, but Arabic is written and read from right to left. As you can see here, La ilaha illallah. Arabic is very delicate in terms of its similar sounding letters, and certain letters are pronounced with thick sound and also some with thin sound. You can see the example now here, the kul, and the second one is qul. Now the difference between kaf and qaf, you can see that they belong to the same family. It has been highlighted with the red. First one is the red and the second one is maroon. So basically they have the same family, red family. But a slight change in the shade changed the meaning as well. Now the kul means eat. Okay, kulu washrabu wa la tusrifu is a famous phrase in the Holy Quran. And kul means say, proclaim. And some surah also start with this kul. Now, apart from consonants, Arabic has also vowels which prolong the sound of a consonant letter. A consonant letter can be prolonged by using a vowel. Now, for example, if you come to the first letter, alif, or ba, or ta, if we speak that simply, if I pronounce that, it will be ba, ta, tha. But as soon as I want to restrict that pronunciation, then a short vowel will come on that one. For example, look here, the example, meem, lam, and kaf. Now on meem, there is a fatha, ma, lam with kasra, li, and kaf also with kasra. So this is basically malik. And in order to prolong the meem sound, you have a vertical fatha on that one, and it is a malik. So malik in nas, the first example, and then malik, which is a bit longer voice, and it means master, maliki yawmiddin. Now we were talking about Arabic vowels. In terms of pronunciation, there are two types of vowels in Arabic. One is short and the second one is long. First we will speak on short vowels. Fatha, kasra, and dhamma are called short vowels. These are also known as zabar, zair, and pesh respectively in some Asian countries. For example, Pakistan and India and so on. Fatha, what is fatha? Fatha is a slanting stroke and always placed over a letter. You can see the example of ba. Okay, now if I say alif, ba, without any harakat, without any vowel, this slanting stroke, it will be ba. But as soon as it comes with a fatha, a slanting stroke, the limitation, the pronunciation is restricted and limited only to 1 second. It's a ba. Now, kasra is a slanting stroke which is placed below a letter. Like you can see that the letter is ba, the second letter of Arabic is ba, but there is a kasra on that, it should be pronounced like a b. The third one is a dhamma. This is an inverted stroke and placed over a letter. So remember that fatha and dhamma, they are placed over a letter, and kasra is placed below a letter. And dhamma, when it is placed on a letter, it makes a sound of like a oo, boo, okay? Or ta with dhamma is with tu. Now, important note, a letter having any of the above strokes, short vowels, must not be prolonged more than 1 second. Here is the common errors, common mistakes that people, you know, do not take care of this one, and they prolong more than 1 second, and sometimes this is, you know, change the meaning as well. So please make sure that fatha, kasra, and dhamma must not be prolonged more than 1 second. And I also want to tell you that these short vowels, also called harakat, you know, three basic strokes. So fatha, kasra, dhamma. The next one, long vowels. I told you about the short vowels. Now long vowels, these are called al-huruful madda. Al-huruf al-madda. Points to be remembered regarding this one. First one, there are three long vowels in Arabic, and they are also called al-huruf al-madda. Madda means to prolong. And these are called letters of prolongation or stretching. And these are alif, waw, and ya. And they, but remember, they must be mute with a skun or jazm. It means that when they are playing the role of a letter of prolongation, there should not be any fatha, kasra, or dhamma on that. But most of the time in the text, it is indicated with a jazm or that, on skun on that. They always come after a letter because they have to prolong the previous letter. So they are basically prolonging the previous letter. An Arabic example, you can find here two examples. The first one in bracket, there is a noon. And noon carries a dhamma on that one. And just after that, there is a waw. Now, waw always have a previous letter with dhamma, okay? Then is a, that can be prolonged. So, noon followed by waw, it will be nu. And next is ha, is a consonant, and this is with the kasra. And this is followed by ya. Remember, when ya is playing a role of harfe madda, or letter of prolongation, the previous letter would be always with kasra. And this he, Now next one is ha and followed by alif. Now remember the word nuhi ha, this is a Quranic word, okay? And it covers all these three letters of prolongation. For example, nu is a vowel, and hi, ya, and ha is alif. So there are three letters, alif, vowel, ya. It is covered by this example. Another example, again, u, here, vowel, the same harf madda, and ti. Now remember, why alif with dhamma has been prolonged? Because it is followed by vowel with sukoon. And the word, the letter ta with kasra ti, follow, you know, it has been prolonged because of ya, that is a harfe madda. And again, noon, na, it has been prolonged because, what is the next letter? Alif. Alif madda. So this is alif madda or vau madda or ya madda, yai madda. So these, you know, prolong that one. In order to understand it better, I think English example, you can find this one here. Like, for example, a. Like, it doesn't all the time give you a short vowel. Also, you know, like father, it has been prolonged, like rather, okay? The time duration for pronouncing a long vowel or harf madda is about 2 seconds. Maximum, you know, about 2 seconds. Not more than 2 seconds until there is some condition that you will learn afterwards. But remember, this is, what is 2 seconds? This is a 2 unit. Of you know, time duration, or 2 normal blinks of eyes. This is basically, you can say father, okay, u ti na, okay. You will find many examples. But in order to remember that what are the haruf e madda, just remember these two words, nu hi ha or u ti na. The proper time should be, duration should be given to the both. To all these words. Next one, in this program, we shall focus on Surah An-Nas. You see, you remember in the very beginning, I introduced that in each program, in each class, we will focus and practice one particular surah. And based on that surah, we will learn a new rule of recitation. Now, this time, we are starting with Surah An-Nas, which and we'll learn an important rule of recitation. Now, before making a practice of Surah An-Nas and introduce a introduction of a new rule, the important points should be remembered. The first one, this is the last surah of the Holy Quran, and this is chapter number 114. It has 7 verses. Okay, now Allah the Almighty has divided the text into surahs, and also the surah has been divided by, the text of surah has been divided by verses. Surah, the text of Surah An-Nas has been divided by Allah the Almighty into 7 verses, including Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim is the first one, and it has 7 verses. Okay, the meaning of its name of this surah is An-Nas, the mankind, humankind, or the people, all right? And the last one, this is the best surah to start learning and teaching the rule of noon gunna. Gunna means strong nasal sound. Okay, there are different categories or different degrees of gunna. But this time, gunna means continuous nasal sound for about 2 seconds. Sustained continuous nasal sound for about 2 seconds in pronunciation. And it is produced from nose pipe, you know, the nose pipe. There are 2 kinds of gunna, nasal sound. One is mim gunna, and the second one is noon gunna. Okay? A gunna letter having strong nasal sound carries a tashdeed or shadda sign over it. You know, 3 cog, like, you know, can say, like a small W. Okay? So this is a sign, a tashdeed sign or shadda sign. When there is a gunna, these 2 letters, noon and mim, they will always carry this sign, tashdeed sign. So here is an example of mim gunna. You follow me? Amma.
Amma.
Now you see that there is a sustained continuous nasal sound, okay, about 2 seconds. Now example of noon gunna is inna. Say
inna.
Now many times the word has come here, the word inna, okay, and this is a example of noon gunna. Now the basic steps to be taken before starting the Holy Quran is fundamental principle is cleanliness, okay, and the first one I will speak on the physical cleanliness. First of all, we should make sure that our mouth is totally clean, our teeth are brushed, okay, and inside is totally clean, because these are the exit point of the holy words, word of Allah the Almighty. Our hands should be clean because we are going to touch the holy words, the holy texts of Allah the Almighty, the Quran and Kareem. And but the most important thing is the spiritual cleanliness. It means that praying to Almighty Allah, that Allah enable us to continue to benefit from the Holy Quran, and seeking refuge with Allah. And this is mentioned in the Holy Quran. For example, you can see here, At-Ta'awwuz. Now, At-Ta'awwuz, this is a command of Allah the Exalted, Allah the Almighty. And you can find the example here in Surah An-Nahl, which is chapter number 16, verse number 99, in which Allah the Almighty says that فَإِذَا قَرَأْتَ الْقُرْآنَ فَاسْتَعِذْ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ. That, O reader of the Holy Quran, when you recite the Holy Quran, seek refuge with Allah from Satan the Rejected. Okay, so this is a commandment of Allah the Almighty, that whenever you are going to recite the Holy Quran, you should seek refuge with Allah from the attacks or evil whispering of Satan. And then this command is implemented in these words, A'udhu billahi minash shaitan rajim. Now remember, the first ta'idh, in the first, that command, Surah An-Nahl, chapter 16, verse 99, it means to seek refuge. And implementing that or following that command, we say, A'udhu billahi. The words are, other words are the same, billahi minash shaitan rajim. We only add A'udhu, I seek refuge. And this A'udhu also has come in the Holy Quran many times. For example, Surah An-Nas, which we are focusing this time, start with Qul A'udhu bi Rabbin Nas, Qul A'udhu bi Rabbil Falaq. Okay? Practice of noon gunna. For your easy practice and understanding the rule, we have highlighted those points where gunna will be made. Strong nasal sound will be made for about how many seconds?
Two seconds.
Two normal blinks of eyes. A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم.
Okay, now make sure that the letter ذال should be pronounced with thin and soft sound. Many people do a mistake here. They do not make a difference between ذال and ذا, which is a buzzing sound. So we are focusing on one rule, which is noon gunna, but at the same time we will pick one letter, similar sounding letter. Okay, this time we have picked dhal. So tip of tongue is touching the front upper teeth, you know, that edge, and you are pronouncing this one softly with thin sound. Dhu, dhu, say?
Dhu.
Dhu, okay. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم
قل okay, so making a sure between that قل كاف and قاف is a thick, okay, and that كاف is a thin, so this means قل means say, proclaim. قل
أعوذ
برب الناس
برب الناس.
Now remember, this is a, you know, the nasal sound. You are making gunna here on annas. This is, you know, it is a vibration in your nose pipe, the sound waves. and this is producing a nasal sound, strong nasal sound. قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ
قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ
مَلِكِ النَّاسِ
مَلِكِ النَّاسِ
إِلَهِ النَّاسِ
إِلَهِ النَّاسِ
مِنْ شَرِّ الْوَسْوَاسِ الْخَنَّاسِ في صدور الناس
الذي يوسوس في صدور الناس.
Okay, جزاكم الله. You see, as I mentioned that we are focusing only one rule of recitation. There may be 10 rules. You know, حروف مدہ are there, then, you know, similar sounding letters, some ikhfa rules, you will learn in next programs. But this time, you are only focusing and learning and practicing Noon Gunna. Okay. Now, this time, as I mentioned that we will, inshallah ta'ala, make a lot of practice. Now, in this way, I will read one line or one verse, and you will read the second, you know, alternately. Okay.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم
قل أعوذ برب الناس
ملك الناس
إله الناس
من شر الوسواس الخناس
الذي يوسوس في صدور الناس
من الجنة والناس.
Okay, thank you very much. Now, next one is common errors. So we have to highlight and rectify those common errors which commonly they are done. Now, apart from highlighted Noon Gunna, which is highlighted with the green color, these three words have been highlighted with red color. The first one is A'udhu. Sometimes it is pronounced like A'uzu. Okay? Make sure that Alif, which is, you know, at the same time becomes Hamza because of Fatha, okay, Hamza Alif. This is only for 1 second. If we prolong that one, then, you know, the pronunciation will be wrong. So, If I say ah, it will be wrong. Now remember, the next letter is Ayn, and Ayn with Dhamma. How much time is needed for Ayn with Dhamma?
2 seconds.
No. I just asked Ayn with Dhamma. 1 second. Ayn with Dhamma is only 1 second. I have not, you know, referred to Vau Madda, which is after that. It has not been highlighted. Okay? When Vau will be added to Ayn with Dhamma, then Ayn sound will be prolonged. Because Vau Madda is a letter of prolongation. So, first one is A. Say A.
A.
U.
U.
One second.
U.
U. But in order to prolong that one, we add the vowel, which is there, the third letter here. We say A-U, A-U.
A-U.
Again, Dhal, soft and thin. Not mingling, not mixing with the sound, with the, like a buzzing sound, like Za. Okay, atuz zakat, not that one, dhu. A'udhu.
A'udhu.
This is the first word which is commonly, you know, mispronounced. Say, A'udhu.
A'udhu.
Next one is Maliki. Now, sometime it is pronounced like Malikin Nas. Remember that Malik means the king. Malikin Nas, king of people. Okay? And Malik means master. Maliki Yawmiddin, master of the day of judgment. So here is Meem with Fatha. So how many seconds you need for that?
One second.
So if I say Ma, is it right?
Yes.
If I say Ma, it's wrong because this is long vowels, you know, is harfe madda, you can find in Surah Al-Fatiha, Maliki Yawmiddin. So here is Malikin Nas. Now the third word, which is also mispronounced, which is with the Saad. Now this Saad, sometime pronounced unintentionally with Fatha, like Yuwaswisu fi Sadurin Nas. So make sure that this Saad, whenever you teach to others, this Saad is with Dhamma. Okay? So it means Sudurin Nas. Yuwaswisu fi Sudurin Nas.
Sudurin Nas.
Okay. You have learned rule of Gunna. You know what is Fatha, Kasra, Dhamma, you know, short vowels and long vowels. Now this is the assignment. Until the next program, next class. Remember that you have to practice a lot so that it becomes your part of nature. So assignment from me, repeat Surah An-Nas in your private time 7 times. If you do in group, in a pair, that will be excellent. Make sure you do not have the highlighted common errors, which I highlighted, you know, with the red one. The three, A'udhu, like Malikin Nas and Sudur, you do not have that one, okay? And wherever you can find, you very nicely, you know, highlight this one and, you know, teach. Identify and practice the examples of Noon Gunna in Surah Al-Jinn. Okay, tell me, Hassan, how many chapters in the Holy Quran?
114.
Okay, so this is chapter number 72. Surah Al-Jinn, chapter number 72. How many times? You have to tell me next time, in next class, how many times the Noon Gunna, not Meem Gunna, Noon Gunna has come in chapter number 72 in part 29. Okay? Now we have learned one particular rule based on Surah An-Nas, rule of Gunna, strong nasal sound, and short vowels and long vowels, and this is the time now to end this class, and it will be very good and full of blessing that if we, as we started with the prayers, we also end, conclude this class with the prayer. Allahumma arhamni.
Allahumma arhamni.
Bil Qur'an al-Azim.
Bil Qur'an al-Azim.
Waj'alhu li.
Waj'alhu li.
Imaman wa.
إماما و
نورا و
نورا و
هدى و رحمة
هدى و رحمة
اللهم ذكرني
اللهم ذكرني
اللهم ذكرني منه
اللهم ذكرني منه
ما نسيت
ما نسيت
وعلمني منه
وعلمني منه
ما جهلت
ما جهلت
وارزقني
وارزقني
تلاوته
تلاوته
آناء الليل والنهار
آناء الليل والنهار
آناء should be long okay آناء الليل والنهار
آناء الليل والنهار
واجعله لي
واجعله لي
حجة يا رب العالمين
حجة يا رب العالمين
آمين
Amen.
O Allah, have mercy on me. Through the great Quran.
Through the great Quran.
And make it for me.
The model.
The light.
Guidance.
And mercy.
O Allah.
Remind me.
Whatever.
I have
forgotten from it.
And teach me.
And teach me.
What I do not know.
what I do not know of it.
Grant me its recitation
during the hours of night
and day
and make it a witness
in my favor
O Lord
of the universe. Okay, Jazakumullah. Viewers of MTA, we hope that you have enjoyed our program. If you have any question or comment or feedback, please write to us at tarteel@mta.tv. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. ورتل القرآن